Now, returning to an earlier story, the Afghan Taliban is maintaining that the US has violated its commitments on troop withdrawal. US forces have started to leave, but the previous US administration had promised all foreign forces would be out by today, May the 1st. Earlier, we spoke to Suhail Shaheen, who is the Taliban's spokesman here in Doha, began by asking him if US personnel would remain a target despite the withdrawal.
There are two parts of this. One part is we had agreement with the American after 18 months negotiation here in Doha. And according to that agreement, they were had committed to withdraw all their troops by May 1st. That they didn't fulfill. So they violated that agreement. And the second phase is that they announced that they will withdraw or pull out all their forces from Afghanistan. So that is a good and a positive step. So two things, the one side is violation of the agreement and the other that they will withdraw all their forces, it is a positive step. Thirdly, now the decision is pending our leadership, what they decide in future that would be implemented. We are awaiting their decision.
You're saying that's a violation because they've not withdrawn by May the 1st, but that was struck with a different leadership in the United States. That was when Donald Trump was president. There's a different leadership now, and they're saying everyone will be out by September the 11th.
We had not struck the deal with a certain person. The deal is with government and the state. So that state is there. And the deal was not only for 4 years, it's forever. So they are legally committed to that agreement. And also they said we are committed to that agreement, but still they did not fulfill what they had made the commitment about troops withdrawal.
Okay. Tell me more broadly then about the idea of peace in Afghanistan. The US is saying they will withdraw, but there's still no agreement between yourself, the Taliban, and the Afghan government. Is there any progress there?
The negotiation started in September, and they are still continuing. And we are committed to a peaceful settlement. That is why we are meeting the negotiation team from the other side. So we are hopeful to reach a settlement through talks and negotiation. That is our hope. And because of that, we are having negotiation.
More on this now with Osama bin Javaid, our correspondent who's been following the negotiations in Doha. Let's pick up on the final point made there by the Taliban spokesman, Osama, the fact that they say they are committed to peace and to a peaceful resolution in Afghanistan. Do the talks reflect that? I mean, is there progress to report?
Well, those are the words that we've been hearing for the last year since the Americans signed the deal with the Taliban in February. But there's little progress on the ground. You've seen the attacks spiking. You've seen the scathing criticism coming from the Afghan government. And if statements are anything to go by, you heard the Taliban spokesman there talk about investigating the Logar attack, in which civilians were killed. And you heard from the Afghan president saying that the Taliban were responsible. So it is going to be a continuation of competing narratives in a very divided space in Afghanistan as US forces prepare to leave. Their formal withdrawal has begun from May the 1st, and according to the US president, will be completed by September the 11th. And this remains to be the sticking point. The Taliban saying that because they signed an agreement and committed that they will withdraw by May the 1st, and the other side saying that the Taliban has not really shown enough progress in severing ties, building, bringing down the level of violence, and negotiating in good faith with the Afghan government. And there's a lot of frustration doing the rounds, not just on part of the Afghan government, but other officials as well, who've been trying to tone down the Taliban's rhetoric in saying that you are a party to the conflict and Afghanistan is not going to look like what it did 20 years ago.
So what did you take from what we heard about I guess, whether US troops would remain a target or not. To clarify, today, May 1st, they were supposed to be all gone if Donald Trump was still the president. He's not. Joe Biden says, as you pointed out, it'll be by September the 11th. So what could happen in the interim?
Well, the Taliban have not declared an all-out war after this agreement expired on May the 1st. You've seen, not just from the spokesman here in Doha, from the political office, but the Taliban spokesman in Kabul, Zabihullah Mujahid, in Afghanistan, saying that their agreement has been void now, that especially that part of the agreement is void. And I asked them point blank, do they remain committed to their side of the agreement, that they will not allow Afghan soil to be not used by elements such as al-Qaeda against any foreign forces? And they say that they remain committed. Suhail Shaheen, after that interview, did tell us that he is going to make sure, he's going to speak to the Taliban high command, and they are awaiting instructions on how to proceed, not just in the battlefield, but also on the diplomatic arena. So you're going to continue to hear these statements where Taliban seem to be ratcheting up the rhetoric that their side of the bargain has been kept and the Americans broke the agreement. But they have not declared that they are going to begin targeting American troops. It's worth noting, since the agreement since last year in February, the Taliban have not targeted foreign troops, but there have been clashes and an escalation of violence between the Taliban and Afghan government forces.
Osama bin Javaid with more there on the current situation in Afghanistan. Thank you, Osama.